Guys are back.
Anyway.
So I guess
talking about scary movies, folks.
I guess the main difference between like a scary movie and like a disgusting movie. You're right. I think the Omen still has like some disturbing elements because like a lot of times the people who try to kill Damien end up dying in pretty horrific ways. So like that's no good for sure. But like
that's no good.
That's no good. I guess if you had a movie like I'm trying to think of like a really like.
You don't need to do this. Sorry, Avery.
I think. Okay, so here's what I'll say. I think the most effective horror movies for me, the ones that like really get my goats. I think I'd be able to. I wouldn't want.
It got all my goats.
It got all my goats. They're just gone. I wouldn't sit down and watch a movie like like body horror movies. Like I wouldn't choose to watch that. However, I don't think it would affect me as something as like the truest scariest thing that a movie can do is remove your sense of safety like in your own home. I think that's what a scary like there's a web series on YouTube. Oh, there's a red chest there.
What do I need it for?
Yeah, that's a good point. There's a YouTube series on the internet called it's called Marble Hornets. They're starting to do a different series now that I haven't been keeping up on as much. But it's like it's all like Slenderman mythos and everything like that. But that gives you that idea of because it's all like found footage stuff, you know. It's presented in that kind of style. But like that kind of removes some of your sense of safety because the Slenderman character. I don't think you want to go down. You do because you have to go down to go out.
Thanks for your input.
I was helping.
Really?
Because like one of the scariest moments of that series for me, because like the Slenderman character only really appeared at like night for like a large portion of the series and like only in certain cases, and then one episode came up later where the whole premise is this guy's making a student film. One of his college friends, he disappears. One of his college friends goes to try and find him and figure out like what happened to him. So he finds all these tapes from the student film that he was making, and it's got all this weird stuff, and it's like documenting all the weirdness that's happening. So like the scariest part for me is there's this one episode where the guy who disappeared, he's in a stable relationship. He's got like a girlfriend or anything. And it's a video from like after all the other like events that have happened in the show.
The deed is done. The dreaded St. John breathes no more.
Bum bum bum.
Sweet.
That's some nice.
You played your part in serving justice to those.
I'm gonna miss these little conversations. Gutter's been running a little too red lately.
Yeah, huh?
Bum bum bum.
Guys, you saw it here first. Whoa. Tom C fucking did it. He didn't even vats. So he's a $130,000 richer Suns Bucks wise.
There you go, folks. I went against my own rule, but it all worked out in the end.
What rule did you go against?
Betting all your money in the last time.
Oh, yeah, true. Yeah.
It's a coward's tactic, but...
It's a spooky move, for sure.
Sometimes you gotta go all in. Anyway, you're mentioning stuff about Crystal Hornets.
Yeah, so...
Whatever.
So they find. So he finds this one video, and it's taken after all of the... All the events of the show up until that point have taken place. So it's like way later. Hey, yo. And he's with his like girlfriend, and they're like really happy, and she walks out, and like she's holding the camera, and she's like, "Oh, hey, honey, I found this video camera. I didn't even know we had." And he's like, "Where'd you find that?" And she's like, "Oh, it was just in this closet." He's like, "Put it away. You gotta put it away right now. Put it away. Put it away." And he gets like super angry, which is like super aggressive, and is like a sign that the Slenderman's about to show up, make a cameo appearance.
That's not good.
And she's like. And it's and like they use like audio distortion like and video tracking to like make it seem even spookier. So all the signs start happening. And so he like almost goes to like to attack her, and she like runs away. It turns down a hallway, and fucking Slenderman's right there, and it's like broad daylight, and it's like breaking all the rules.
Yeah,
because you're not Slenderman's not allowed to come in daytime. That's not all right.
Is that like towards the end of the series?
It's towards the end of one of the seasons.
I'm certainly getting hit by radiation pretty hard. Probably because my armor's completely.
That
locked.
Would be my guess. Yeah. I think your radiation reduction is drastically decreased when you're not wearing armor like that. And then there's this other episode where
maybe not worth exploring at this time.
The main character is like sleeping, and he does like a Paranormal Activity style, like I'm just gonna record what happens when I sleep because blah 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 blah. And then
it's always a mistake.
One of the characters, affectionately known as Masky. In the community, because he wears a mask all the time.
Makes sense.
He shows up, and, like, first thing you just see him staring out from outside the window. The screen, like, does the tracking thing. Then he's sitting on, like, then he's standing on, like, the foot of the person's bed. Then it does another tracking thing, and he's, like, looking straight at the camera. Super spooky.
Not into it.
No, not into it whatsoever. But, like, that's
not
the thing.
Not for me.
That's the thing that, like, removes the safety of your home.
Yeah.
Like, that's what really gets me as far as...
No, we've spoken about this before, too. The real-life biggest scary thing you've ever had. The thing that scares you the most in your life was a story similar to that.
Yeah, that's no good.
There's a story
I still have not found that. I've looked for it very hard.
Yeah, it was a story that...
Is this Hangman's Alley?
Basically, it was, that's too bad about your life.
Yeah, I got a face full of lasers.
Yeah, it was on some kind of like police show.
No, I've always told the story was that it was on Unsolved Mysteries.
On Unsolved Mysteries.
But I don't know if it is or not, because I've been looking for it. I haven't been able to find it.
Yeah, but the idea was generally that there's this guy who would break into people's houses while they were asleep. He would put flour all over his face, sit on your bed, and just look at you.
Yeah. It was super creepy, and then also he ate people's ham for some reason.
Ham?
I remember vividly, there was one, there was a scene that they would have, because they were like, this guy would go into fucking people's fucking kitchens, and then
what do you mean a missing required ammo?
Oh, it does it sometimes. It's just a power armor glitch. Really? Also, I love that animation. Did you drop power armor? Why? What's happening?
Don't really know. It's very confusing.
Drop and pick it up again?
Might not even have it anymore.
You got plenty of fusion cores.
There you go. That was weird.
Yeah, sometimes it likes doing that.
Anyway, yeah, no, that was always a terrific story of pure horror and fear and undelight. I remember you told my story and said, no, sir. Does not work for me. Well, I wonder what makes people become that crazy. Here's my problem. They're scary things, but really, why are humans so, like, scary? Is it just that, like, when a human decides to no longer follow, like, societal norms? Because, like, it's not inherently terrible that someone is doing that thing. Unless they're, like, hurting somebody.
I think it's scary from, like, the perspective of, it's like... It's one of those things where, like...
Not a very
in many ways, the things that are most familiar to us are also things that are the most scary... Because, like, all it takes is, like, such a minor change to go from, like, something we know to, like, being able to almost not comprehend why this normal thing is now different, mm-hmm. You know?
Yeah.
It's like how you always say it in Tim and Eric sketches. They would always, like, they got their eyes pecked out by crows, but then, like, they were just like, yeah, we just got our eyes pecked out by crows.
Yeah,
they're like treating it like a totally normal thing that happens.
Yeah, hated it.
Yeah.
Hate that. I'm sure they knew that was, you know, like...
Yeah, no, they were definitely going for that.
It was disturbing. That always is like, too much for me. Like, whenever, like, someone is just cool with an unbelievably awful circumstance, that's, like, what's rough to me.
Yeah.
That happens a lot. It happens a whole lot. That's one of the reasons, like, stuff like Ghost in the Shell, where, like, she tries to, like, open up that one thing, like, that one, like, Tachikoma, like, thing, and she does it by ripping her own arms off, but, like, she still, like, moves around stuff. You know, that's real hardcore. That's what, like, that's why that kind of stuff bothers me, where they can kind of, like, just endure unhuman-like things without pain.
Yeah, I guess that would explain why, Akira's so scary, too.
Yeah. Because, like, his arm gets mutated or whatever. There's a whole lot of stuff that goes bad there.
People do a lot of talking, that's for sure. Talk, talk, talk.
Talk, talk,
all I want to do is talk from home.
People are getting real shot, too. It's just great. Anyway, yeah, just that kind of stuff. Found the basketball hoop, though. Watch me, like, sink this without any kind of concern, though. I'm going to talk a slam dunk right now. Are you serious?
That's some real Air Jordan right there. Truly, you are the basket man.
Does that count as a score? Did I out laser?
I don't think anyone's broken the laws of gravity like that.
Yeah. I don't know. Anyway. So yeah, that's, I don't know. I can't really say with authority what the scariest movie I ever saw was, cuz I really haven't seen very many. And I just don't like scary things, so I don't watch them. I think I saw The Shining a long time ago.
I don't think I've ever seen that.
You ever watched The Shining?
No.
What is all this explosion? That surprised me. You seem like a classics guy.
Oh, yeah, dude. I remember The Watcher, too.
No, we all know The Watcher. We talk about it too much, and it's too scary.
Yeah, that's... I wonder what ever came of that.
Although I don't know if our Deadly Dice audience has ever heard about The Watcher.
No, I don't think so. I think that might have been a raw run.
That's what this song's about, is about our runs. It's all about the crying. Next week you're going to be crying. Because I'm going to win that DD.
Dude, you might. This is ultimate. This is some straight up Sanders Trump shit going on. It's the ultimate in contention.
I made an ultimatum to you. You got to go all in plus.
I have to do at least one deadly dice.
Unless you want to just tie it up.
Which, who knows even what that would do?
Overtime? Not likely.
No, very unlikely.
Probably. We would probably work to do undertime.
We could somehow remove time.
We would unrelease the final episode and leave it as a cliffhanger.
Ooh, I like that.
I like that. That way you'd go, did he do it? The answer would be yes, but we'll release it next week and we'll just make it 5-minute episodes.
Dude, don't you just love it when your iPhone is arbitrarily just like, no, I don't know what the internet is.
Oh, it's all the time.
What's that? You want me to connect to the internet? No, I'm sorry. I'm trying to cut down. I appreciate the offer, but thanks.
No, thank you. You're funny. Hey, I found this place. I'm gonna go there and hang out.
Where are you going?
Dimon City.
I'm going to Dimon City.
Oh yeah, dude. So
everything's terrible, guys. That's what you need to learn. Never feel safe. Always feel on edge. Just generally carry with you an air of anxiousness, mm-hmm, and anxiety. That's gonna make you feel healthy. It's gonna make you feel prepared for the definite scary things that are always waiting for you behind every corner.
Not, folks,
you don't even have a door to protect you. It's behind every corner.
I recently had to face a fear of mine, very recently actually, when there was a wasp in my room.
Oh, really?
Yes. I had a good friend over, and she looked up towards the ceiling, discovered there's just a wasp hanging out up there. Chilling. But by chilling, I mean being very active. Walking around, fluttering his wings, really getting into it. And so, normally, I'm a live and let be kind of guy.
I got it.
Except, this was either a wasp. It wasn't a yellow jacket. It wasn't big enough. Or it was too big. But, I knew this was something that had to be dealt with.
Right.
Because I can't live... Pro tip, guys, I'm scared of stinging insects in general. Specifically flying ones, but mostly skinny guys. Just mostly stingy guys, sorry. So, like, when it was flying around, I couldn't really rest.
No. I would have a hard time with that.
I had a cup strategy I was considering of just to let it kind of get out of here through peaceful means. But I knew that once I got in that cup, it was go time for that wasp. It wasn't going to go peacefully. So I just decided that it had to be done. I'm not interested in taking life from anybody.
Yeah.
As it's precious and so impossibly rare that I would never take it from even an insect purposefully. However, the insect made the greatest mistake of all, which was to be in my room.
Right.
A penalty of which applies to humans as well, and that's death for going into my room uninvited. So it was hanging out on a poster. That was my biggest concern. I don't want to ruin a poster. But also, I don't have a fly swatter in the house. All I had was my slippers, which, as we know, short-ranged weapon.
Yeah, that's a melee weapon at best.
Yeah, medieval fighters used to take slippers out, ride on horses, and from horseback they would slap people in the face. And that part, you know, those people weren't very victorious. That's why you don't see a lot of medieval slippers. It's true, though. But anyway, so it's on a poster. He's moving a little bit. What's happening? What is happening? This is horrifying. That's horrifying.
Yeah, I think you got triggered for a dialogue.
I'm like a million miles away. I'm like nowhere near this.
Yeah. I know he had a little neon sign. That's neat.
Like the camera decided to perv on that little girl.
That's not surprising. This game is made in Japan, right? What?
Yeah. Don't make me shut down this little stand of yours. I've never seen this in my life.
Really?
Yeah.
It's a health hazard, Chang. It's a profit hazard, is what I say. I manage the walk, and I'll do it without your interference. Thank you very much. But I'm busy, man. Things to do, people to see.
I like your name. Anyway, yeah, so long story short, I killed a wasp with a sliver.
Long story short, I murdered a wasp.
But I had to go, like, in 100% on it. Because you can't, if you just half it, you know what you get?
Half a live wasp.
No, you get stung. That's what you get, straight up. You go in, you don't commit to this. He's just going to say, okay, this guy wants to kill me, and I have every ability to defend myself as a wasp. So I just wasn't going to do it. I fully committed. I'm talking deep lunge. Like just...
Tom, I'm going to stop you there. Cliffhanger this wasp story. The next learning episode of Sons of Idiot.
No
guys,
way.
We're going to have to see what happens to this wasp.
See ya.
See ya.